This is the first of many videos which will be exploring the style that we see in Salman Rushdie's Midnight's Children. In this video, we're going to be looking simply at the genres of discourse, meaning how would you characterize this novel? This novel can be characterized in three different ways. It can be seen as an autobiography of the protagonist, it can be seen as a true fairy tale, and it can also be seen as a historical representation of the partition time in India. So let's first of all look at the autobiography. Obviously, we know that Salim is 30 years old, and there are 30 chapters in the book. So we see, and when he's in his pickling factory, we see that there are 30 pickle jars already done, and there's one that hasn't been finished yet, so that leads us to believe that's the one for future stories. So, and obviously this whole story, the whole book is about Salim's history, his autobiography. The book is broken down into three portions, about 30 years prior to partition, and then, so the span goes 30 years prior to partition, then 30 years after partition. So only the after partition, of course, really matters to us and to the main character and his tie into the novel. So this can be seen, like I said, as an autobiography book of Salim just simply telling his life story, but there is so much more to it. Another important element in the discourse is the element of being like a fairy tale. And actually we call that element magical realism. The definition of magical realism is up here, but basically just it takes things that we consider magical and integrates them into the fictional world of the literature, and it's seen as totally ordinary. So Gabriel Garcia Marquez and Jorge Luis Borges are two South American authors who are kind of considered to be the fathers of magical realism. And Rushdie was heavily influenced both by Marquez and, of course, by Faulkner, as I've already mentioned. Another element to see this as a fairy tale, of course, are all the myths of ancient India. India existed long before it was India, and long before it was even a British colony. And with that long history, that long lineage, comes a lot of myths from the Hindu and from the Hindu religion and from all of the other people that came through and made the area that is now called India their home. So there are tons of myths. You might even say that the current idea of India was a myth, but we'll get into that later on. Then, of course, another element of magical realism that we see in the novel is definitely the Midnight's Children's Conference. That's all the Midnight's Children talking in Salim's head about, you know, what to do in India. Lastly, besides seeing it as a fairy tale or just a strict autobiography, we have to acknowledge the historical elements that are in there. Salim not only tells his own story and mixing in some of the myths from the country itself, but he's handcuffed to history. So it's also a historical look at the country of India, both prior to partition and then, of course, after partition. So this novel not only gives us the story of Salim in an autobiographical aspect, and not only brings in the fantastical myths of India in the magical realism, but it also gives us a historical picture of India during this time. Some of the historical issues or historical events are definitely true, and some are fictionalized. A good example of this is the number 581. That's the number of Midnight's Children that remain after the first that lived to being 12 and 13 years old. That happens to correspond with a number of representatives in the Indian Parliament. So that was no coincidence, those numbers are the same. And then, of course, the character of the hummingbird in the novel Midnight's Children, it's just a single man that's represented. But in the real historical events, that movement was the optimist movement, not just represented by a single man. So that kind of gives you an overview of this book. It's not only, you can't just classify this novel into one mode of discourse. It is an autobiography, it is a fairy tale, and it is a history lesson or a historical novel. So it's all three of them wrapped up into one.